These days, no one. No one wants to sweat, change your clothes, stink, put deodorant, have all that shiz going on. No one wants it. You think it's a waste of time. But here comes the Abby details. The Abby details. First of all, I'm gonna tell everyone how much weight I actually lost to make this video actually more interesting, since you know what, I'm so boring. So today I'm gonna talk about how I lost weight and how I went from this to this. Before I lost weight, I wanna actually let people know what my weight was. I was a good 95 kilo. And maybe more, which is 202 pounds. And I reduced myself into 55 kilos, which is 121 pounds. Basically, I lost 40 kilos, which is like 88 pounds. Before we jump to conclusions that I lost 88 pounds in a very short time, I can honestly say that I lost 59 pounds actually in a matter of 5 months, 5 to 6 months. The rest kind of became slower as your body gets used to doing the same routine all the time. So it reacts slowly. So basically, I want to start with the good stuff right now. Things you came for, not my speech. I want to talk about how I went from a size almost 18 to 22 to a size almost between 4 to 7. Sometimes between stores it wavers, but yeah. I just want everyone to know that there was no exercise at all. No running. No walking. Nope, no dancing either. No benching. No starving. No aerobics. So basically, I didn't follow any diet plans, anything. No program, no copying off the internet, no Bigfoot, Littlefoot, Mediumfoot diet exercise, diet plan, I don't know. I didn't follow anything like that. So let's get down to the basics, the real tips, other than watching me blabber all the time. Rule number one. See how beautiful these are. See how... Get rid of your... Do not eat chocolate. Get rid of the Twix. Get rid of the candy. Get rid of all of it. Do not go anywhere next to things that have sugar. Do not eat what your grandma made for your birthday. And do not cheat and go into your friend's lunchbox and eat her piece of chocolate donut, you nasty. Basically, do not eat anything with sugar. Sugar is actually bad and these products are there to kill you. Stay away from these unhealthy products. The people who make them do not care about how much weight you put on and what diseases come with what weight you put on. I don't know if that was mean, but I suffered from some stuff because I was overweight, so... So yeah, after you're done with number one and you finish staying away from your mother's pie, and the sugars you can go next to are sugars that are healthy for you. Sugars like apple. Apple contains sugar, and so do all the other fruits like banana, pineapple, strawberry, grape, blackberry, blueberry, oranges. And also other things that have sugar which is good for you is honey. Some people say honey can make you put on weight, but no. You have to choose the correct honey and actually see what you're buying, not just buy it blindly. Not all honey actually contains sugar. Now, there are certain types of natural God-given food that actually has a lot of ingredients that, you know, that helps you lose weight. Number one, the best thing you can invest in is this fruit called pineapple. Pineapple is so good for you. It has natural acid inside it that helps collaborate with their acids in your stomach, and it mixes and makes your digestive system more and more healthy and more fast. It makes you digest your food really quickly and also helps with the metabolism. Another very good natural ingredient that helps to lose weight, which is also acidic, is lemon. That too, real lemon. Anyways, So lemon actually is also acidic. It helps decrease fat that is deposited in your body, which is very helpful because those kind of things helped me through my time. I mean, oh my god. You can take lemon and use it on anything you like. Before you go to sleep, mix honey, mix lemon, hot water, and go to sleep. It's my favorite thing to have. That's why I'm so happy, you know. Another type of food that helps digest fast and detoxes you is prunes. Prunes is a very good, tasty, sweet fruit that is out there. You should really invest into buying something like that because it helps you. I mean, if this is your plan and you don't want to exercise, go for it. Another thing that is also important in your new found change is tea. I drink a lot of green tea. Yes, I admit it. Green tea is the best. It has hypnotized me. Green tea, I love it. This actually helped me so much. Yes, green tea helped me 1,000 times better than pineapple, raisins, prunes, honey, and lemon. It helped me to the core. What you do is that you have it 3 times a day. I used to have it 4, but that's only after my body started getting used to it. What green tea does is that it speeds up your metabolism. Who wouldn't want that sped up? Let's say the bathroom becomes your friend after that. What you want to do is when you go to college, work, or school, have this before you go. This will start off your morning. It's a good energizer, it's good for detox, and metabolizes you. If you can say that. Well, it's good for your metabolism. The thing about green tea is that don't have it on an empty stomach. Only in the morning that's acceptable. But on the other parts of the day, have it 30 minutes to 1 hour after every meal. Because first, you want your body's stomach's acids to digest your food. And when it starts digesting your food, then you take the green tea 30 minutes to 1 hour later. And then it starts speeding up your metabolism. So now everything's working together and becoming faster, digesting faster. And yeah, your bathroom will be your friend by the end of the day. Another thing. When you start doing this for at least 3 months straight, every day, green tea, 3 times a day, morning, noon, and evening. If you do this, your body will start getting accustomed to this. You want to, like, dose it up. You have to buy oolong tea. Oolong tea. Yeah, you want to buy the oolong tea. Legends of China, eh? So about oolong tea, it is twice as strong as green tea. Do not start oolong like a hero and not start green tea. Your body needs to get used to it. Don't start without starting green tea. You want to do the same thing 3 times a day as green tea. You'll start seeing major results, woman or man. I lost a good 4 kilos in 1 month, being at least a good 10 to 8 pounds in a month. Thing is that green tea does not work when you're on a full stomach or when you're on a half stomach. Basically, within this sort of happy diet, you want to minimize your eating habits. Okay, let's get this straight. Let's get this out in the open, clear and everything like that. I used to eat 4 to 5 chicken legs from KFC. Not a day, at least once a month. But still, now I don't eat KFC. But if I did, I would eat 1 or 2. You have to minimize your eating habits. Your stomach is this small. If you pack it with the amount you eat, which is obviously this much, you're cramping and making the walls expand. The less you eat, and the more balanced you eat, your stomach contracts and becomes back to its normal size. You don't want to keep expanding your stomach, because then, once you expand it, and it's expanding more, you get less full with the more you eat, making it expand slowly, 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 slowly after time until it disappears from the screen. Disappeared. You ate too much. You really want to reduce your portions. Start eating stuff like salad, pasta, no pizza, no burgers. Stay away from loads of bread. Just don't include it in your diet. No rice. Things you can eat is grilled stuff like chicken, grilled vegetables. Vegetables are good. I'm not talking about french fries. Eat as many vegetables as you can. I'm not telling you to become vegetarian. Eat chicken, grilled chicken. You can eat beef. Don't have it soaking in gravy or barbecue sauce. That is unhealthy. You can eat sausages. Just don't eat a lot of sausages. Sometimes you may get hungry. Your body is not used to eating such less food. This would be your version of cheating, but cheating in a healthy way. Take fruit bars or fruit bars. You can have Kellogg's, cashew, you can have anything. Just have it like a snack bar. Take it, eat it at work, eat it at home, eat it during your snack time, eat it during a movie. Popcorn is good too. You also want to snack on nuts. If you want to snack more, walnuts, almonds, pecans, macadamia, and all the other nuts except for peanuts. Don't eat peanuts. And definitely not peanut butter. Do not eat peanut butter. If you want to eat peanut butter, 1 teaspoon a day, not more. Make sense? And also another process is water. I drink this before I go to bed every night because when you wake up, all of the toxins that you carry through the day get released in the you-know-where. So water is a really good thing that you should have in your daily life, whether you needed me to say that or not. I really never believed in the 8 glasses a day kind of thing. I just drank this water bottle throughout the day. I don't know why I'm waving this around. It's getting really funny. Don't have a lot of dairy products like ice cream. You can have frozen yogurt. You can have low-fat ice creams. Try to cut down on desserts. Anything that involves sweets. Cheese. Cheese can be really, 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 really fattening. And it can really get onto your hips. And if you're a guy, you will get hips. Not that I'm complaining. If you want to eat chocolate, you're dying. You're on your last leg. It's like you're surrounded in a desert. You have nothing but a piece of chocolate that you're craving. Fine. Have dark chocolate. That really helps. Because dark chocolate, it has some nutrition facts that are good for you. It has some nutrients. And if you're really dying to have something that is not fruit, punch some biscuits for a snack. Like digestive biscuits, glucose biscuits. Biscuits that do not include sugar on top, sprinkles. Don't cheat. You're only fooling yourself. Don't cheat. And one more thing, if you ever get hungry, soup can fill you up like, you know, I used to have it all the time and I loved it. Now, here comes the uninteresting part, counting calories. An average woman is supposed to eat at least over 1,000 calories a day, including meals. What I did was make sure I count a lot of my calories. If I was eating a snack bar and that was 100 calories, I made sure that in my head I knew what I was keeping count on. You should always keep count of your calories. Things you should look out for in your nutritional facts. I'm gonna make this simple for you. So, here you have your calories. It's 160, which is good. The thing you want to stay out and look for is trans. Trans fat should not be over 8%. Sugars should not be over 12 grams or 9 grams if you could actually get products that way. Never take anything that is over 200 calories. That is not good. Always look at your serving size and see if it's worth it. Remember this about nutritional facts. Always look at the calories, always look at the sugar, always look at the trans fats. Now that you got that down, so for me, I lost a lot of weight after 5 months. Doing all of what I did right now, now I'm gonna summarize everything I just said. 1 green tea in the morning, 1 green tea in the afternoon, 1 green tea in the evening, honey and lemon with hot water in the night. Throughout the day, eat fruit, vegetables, grilled chicken, meat without heavy sauces, snack on nutritional bars. The only reason I know that this process will be effective is that my sister tried it and she lost 8 kilograms in a month just doing what I did. And the thing is that I'm experienced in trying to lose weight from a long time. I also did go to fitness first and I did lose some weight like at first, but then I had to move. I didn't have gym access, so I had to make my own diet plan. So that's basically part of the whole thing of how I lost weight. I hope that whoever tries the green tea, because that is the primary ingredient in this whole entire freaking weight loss thing. I want people to tell me if they have seen results. I saw a lot of results. Sorry I look like a mess for this video. I've been out almost 12 hours. My hair is a mess. My makeup's all over the place. So, boshes. Anyways, that's the end of the tutorial. If there's any more questions, feel free to follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Keek. Don't forget to also follow me on Facebook. And subscribe to my YouTube channel. Send in requests. Hope it works for everyone. And have a great day. Okay? Ciao. Things you want to actually have that do contain some sort of sugar. Fruits. You see this? This ain't hard to eat. Maybe the label. You know it. Anyways. Okay. Get rid of it! Not cheat on it by going to your friend's lunchbox and eat. Wonderful routine that you're gonna encounter with and take up, because Abigail said so.